How did the panel go?
It was great. The panel was, it's just a really funny mix of people. You know, you've got such different perspectives. And so, you know, anytime you get that group of people together and you're just talking about comedy, it's bound to just get like super loose. And we went off on all these bizarre tangents where it's like, what was the question again? What are we talking about? It was great, though.
Yeah, and the audience got a lot out of it today. They're quite engaged.
They all seem to really dig it. So, yeah.
Brilliant.
Okay, so we touched a little bit on your film earlier. Let's go back a little bit again. And if you could just start by telling audiences what the film's about.
Yeah, The Kings of Summer is about three boys who run away into the woods and build a house. And it is very much a throwback to sort of Stand By Me or early Amblin movies like Goonies. And it's just about... at the end of the day, like, look, the plot is about these kids who run away and build a house in the woods. The movie is really about eliciting the feeling of walking out of the theater and saying, God damn, being 14 was the best. Mm. And then immediately following that up with, thank God I'm done with that because that's the most painful, horrible, awkward time in my life.
Yeah.
I guess it's just about that awkward time in your life when you think you have everything figured out and yet you know nothing.
You really don't.
Yeah.
You referenced The Goonies and Stand By Me, two amazing films. What is it about those films that really resonates with you and makes it so special enough for you to want to,
Look, I feel honored that reviews are even comparing us to those movies. That's ridiculous. Those are the movies that I grew up on and the movies that made me want to be a filmmaker. I think the thing about those movies that resonates is that they were films. You know, they were start to finish films. They were like great pieces of content with great characters and a great arc and great stories. And then if they were everything else was icing. Everything else that came on top of it was like an added bonus. If it was funny, great. If it's adventurous, great. But like they were stories that you invested in the characters. Whereas now, things just feel really disposable. Like those feel like movies, you know, like films. And like film, like when someone's like, oh, it's a film, normally they're like trying to be real hoity-toity and like talk about something that's really artsy. But like those movies like feel cohesive and they feel together. And we just don't make movies like that anymore.
Absolutely. Do you feel like you're a long-lost Goonie then?
Yeah. In fact, I want to try and set up a screening, like a double feature of Goonies with Kings of Summer before release as a promo thing, and I want to try and get the Goonies cast with my cast. I just think that'd be like an incredible photo op.
That would be amazing. Yeah. And I suppose the last question really to ask you is, what do you think audiences will take away, or what do you want them to take away from Kings of Summer?
I just want them to remember that like comedy can be beautiful and heartbreaking and so many different things. You know, it doesn't have to just be like very simple and just jokes. Like you can invest someone emotionally in a comedy and you can have it, you can walk out of it and be like, great, I'm glad I spent my money to go to a theater and see that.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. Well, listen, we wish you all the very best of luck. Pleasure. Lovely to meet you again. Cheers. Yeah.